Hey y'all, what's poppin'? It's your girl Jada with the Tea, and I got so much tea to spill for y'all today, so y'all get ready to sit back, relax, and get ready to sip this tea, honey. So, let's get right into it. We're gonna jump right in. First topic is about the rapper Waka Flocka. Y'all, we haven't heard about Waka Flocka in so long. He been missing from the hip-hop scene for a good minute, y'all. His last hit song was I Go Hard in the Paint. And we haven't heard from him. The last time I've seen him, I know, was on Growing Up in Hip Hop, Atlanta, I want to say, when he was on there with his wife Tammy Roman. No, Tammy Riviere, that's her name. And he was on, they was on Love and Hip Hop Atlanta. But other than that, we haven't heard a scene from Waka Flocka in a minute. So Waka has took to Instagram to say that he's going into the new year with a new mindset, y'all. He's starting his new year revolution. Y'all already know the new year coming up, so everybody be like, new year, new me, all that madness. So Waka basically saying that any beef he has had with anyone is all over. He said that he going in and into the new year with a new mindset. So according to Waka, in a video he posts that he posted on Instagram, he said that I don't got no more beef, argument, smoke, anger towards nobody. If we ever had problems, I'm telling you right now, for me it's over. That is what Waka Flocka has said. He said he don't got no more beef with nobody, y'all. And I feel him, like, you want to go in the new year drama free, honey. He said he leaving all that drama behind. There's no more beef, no more smoke. He not trying to beef with nobody. He said he ain't no more beef on my end. If y'all still beefing, then that's y'all, but he done with it. So I feel him on that. So basically, right after Waka made that video, he made a statement saying that he's been done with the hip-hop game, which we all know he hasn't been. He hasn't made any new music in a long time. So, but we've been wondering where he at. We've been waiting on this Waka and Gucci Mane reunion. So, you know, everybody been waiting on that. But he said he been done with hip-hop. So, Waka told a TMZ reporter, Raquel Harper, that he been gave up his rap career. He said he did what he came to do in the game, and now it's time for what's next. Whatever next he want to do, I did what I came to do. I made past $30 million. Everybody that I started with is rich, happy, and got kids. My right-hand man that was running the streets with me is a pastor now. Life changed for me. People still want me to be hard in the paint. Why? I'm 32 years old. I'm a grown man. How y'all, what y'all feel about that? How y'all feel? Waka, he set a mouthful, honey. Like, how y'all feel about that? He basically said that he done with the rap game. He done with the hip-hop scene. He ain't in it no more. He said he ready to settle down and have a family. Him and Tammy thinking about having a baby. They trying to have a baby. And they trying to get their life back on track. Their own relationship is going good now. So, you know, he ready to settle down. He don't want to be in that rap game no more. He don't want to be out here in these beefs no more. He don't want to be fighting and arguing no more. He just want to be good. So I feel him on that. I'm glad he's growing and maturing into, you know, a grown man. He said, like you said, he ain't that same person who created Hard in the Paint years and years ago. He was young. He was first coming out. He was super, super young. So he was like, I'm not that boy no more. I'm 32 years old now. I'm a grown man. So he basically saying he need to start acting like a grown man. He need to handle his business. He need to be there for his family. He want to start a new family. And, you know, I feel him on that. I'm not mad at him. He been going out the game for a good while now anyway. So it's not like we missing anything, because he haven't been there. So it's not like he just, you know, up and quit it. He been fell off the hip-hop scene. So it's not like we missing too much. I mean, it would have been good to hear some new music from him to see how he have evolved from when he first started to now. But like he said he got his money. Ben got his money up. He ready to do him. So that's good for Waka Flocka, y'all. How y'all feel about that? I know a lot of people was waiting on that Waka and Gucci Mane, you know, for them to make up and have that reunion. But, you know, Walker said he done with the beef. So he said if anybody want to sit down and talk, that they could sit down and talk like grown men and squash whatever beef they have. But he said he not finna argue with nobody. And he done with this rap game. So I feel him on that, y'all. We can't be mad at him because he want to be done. He want to live his best life. So that's good for Walker. All right, y'all. We're going to take a little quick break.
Some days things just take way too much of my energy. I look up and the whole room's spinning. You take my cares away. I can so overcomplicate. People tell me to medicate. Feel my blood running.
Breathing by Ariana Grande, and we're on to topic number two, y'all. All right, so on Monday, GQ magazine announced that Serena Williams was going to be their Woman of the Year and on the cover, but Serena's cover was met with so much controversy, y'all. The fans pointed out that the word men was crossed out on the cover and was replaced with the word woman in quotation marks. It was said that Virgil Abloh contributed to the handwriting on the cover. The research manager of GQ magazine chimed in and said that the writing of the words in quotation marks are part of Virgil's style. So it's just not just something he just did to make the fans mad. This is something he always does. This is part of his style. The research manager encouraged the fans to go look at some more of his work to see that this is how he always writes. So the fans, but the fans weren't here for it, y'all. The fans was like, no, no, honey, we not here for that. We don't want to hear all that mess about, oh, this is how he usually writes. No. The fans was just going off in the comments, y'all. Like, Shade Room made a post about it on Instagram, and the fans was going in. Like, one fan quoted, quote, said that, y'all be doing Serena so dirty. She is gorgeous and so sweet and literally a living, breathing legend among us all. Y'all will find any way possible to disrespect her or put her down, to throw shade, thinking y'all slick. Girl, the fans was snapping, honey. The fans was not having it. We done had to deal with so much crap with dealing with Serena Williams this year. Like, every time Serena did something, they just tried to bring her down. They just kept coming for her. They kept throwing shade, honey. They was trying to say she was cheating. They're trying to make it like she was didn't have good sportsmanship. Like, people was really coming for Serena this year. And baby was trying to just have her hashtag black girl magic. Serena was trying to be out here living her best life, doing what she do. And they was hating. They was mad. So I see where the fans coming from. The fans are being a little overprotective. They're offensive right there right now because they're mad. Like, they like, y'all keep coming for her. Y'all keep attacking her. So we gonna defend her because y'all keep attacking her. But really, y'all, my feelings about the situation is, I think the fans took it, blew it out of proportion. I think the fans took it the wrong way. I don't think when they made the cover and Virgil did the writing style of the cover, I don't think he meant anything by it. I think he crossed out the word men and put woman because GQ magazine usually has men on their cover, and it's such an honor for them to put a woman on there, especially a black female like Serena Williams. And it's just an honor because it's like, look, GQ usually have men on here, but look who made it to the cover, a woman, Serena Williams. I think that's why they crossed the word men out and put women in quotation marks, because like, it's not a man's world anymore. The women are out here trying to get it. Women are out here doing their thing. And we out here making it known that men ain't the only ones who can be good at sports or be the breadwinners in the family. The women can do it as well. So I just think the fans was taking it. They was being a little defensive, y'all. They was being a little defensive. But I understand why they was being defensive, because Serena has dealt with so much crap this year. It's just ridiculous. Like, crap after crap. Like, them making so many accusations about her that are not true and trying to bring her character down and everything. So kudos to the fans for sticking up and defending Serena. But I think the cover looks good, and I think that they didn't mean anything by it. So, the only person that has not made a comment about this cover is Serena herself. So, I would like to know what Serena thinks about it. How does she feel? Does she think they was throwing shade at her on the cover? Or does she think it was just a misunderstanding between the fans and the cover itself? I want to know, because it just seemed like a big misunderstanding. And I think Serena should, you know, make a comment. She should put something out there to let us know, hey sis, like, just let us know, sis, if everything good. Was they really trying to shade you, sis, or is it just a miscommunication? Let us know, sis, because you know we got your back. So just let us know. Do we really need to be going in the comments, or do we need to fall back? Let us know, Serena. But yeah, I just think it was a big misunderstanding, y'all. I don't think it was all too serious, but the fans was not having it. They was not having it. Like, the comments was real crazy. If y'all go look at the post, y'all will see the comments. They was not playing with about Serena, y'all. All right, y'all. We're going to take another quick break, and we'll be back in a moment.
love to see you shine in the night like a diamond you are.
All right, welcome back, y'all. That was Khalid with Better. And now we're going to move on into the next topic, y'all. So we're going to talk about Young Miami, the new female rapper in the new group called the City Girls. She is one of two members. And she just recently did an interview on The Breakfast Club. So she talked about the controversy tweet that she posted a while back before she became real famous. And she posted a tweet on Twitter talking about basically saying that if her son was gay, she would beat him. So they asked her about that controversy tweet that she tweeted, because, you know, a lot of the City Girls fans, a big chunk of them are gay, and the gay community does support them really hard, and they're from Miami. So they was really offended by what she said, because they felt like, why would you say you would beat him instead of just love him for who he is, I guess. So basically, I'm gonna tell y'all what she said. So Young Miami stated that if she saw anything gay in her son, that she would beat him. She then goes on to say that she doesn't have nothing against gay people. I just want my son. I just don't want my son to be gay. I hang around a lot of gay people all the time. I mean, my stylist is gay. So how y'all feel about that? I feel people always use the well, my friend gay, so that don't mean you know, that don't mean I don't like gay people, or they love to say, you know, well, my friend's black, so that doesn't mean I'm racist. Just because you hang around or you have one friend that is gay or whatever doesn't mean that you discriminate towards them or you feel some type of way. But again, like she said, she hang around gay people all the time and she don't have a problem with gay people. She just wouldn't want her son to be gay. Which is, I mean, a lot of mothers feel like that when they have a son, but even if you feel like that, why would you say that you would beat him? Why just not say you would accept him and love him for who he is? Because that's all we need in this world. We need more love and acceptance in this world, not violence. That's promoting, it seemed kind of like you're promoting violence against somebody being gay, or is something wrong with them because they're gay. So you basically saying, you promoting the violence and that you don't want your son to be gay because that's not something good or something you would want him to be. So I don't know how y'all feel about this. I saw in the comments of the video that's going around on Instagram and stuff, of the interview with the Breakfast Club, I saw a lot of fans mad about what she said. A lot of them felt some type of way. They didn't agree with what she said and they was just like, why would you even say that on the air? The dude from Love and Hip Hop, from one of the Love and Hip Hop's, Milan Christopher, he came out on Love and Hip Hop as being gay, and it was very hard for him to come out. And I think he's he does something in the music business, but he came out as gay, and he really supports and loves the City Girls, and he goes hard for them. So when he saw, when he listened to that interview, he said that it really hurted him, and he felt that it was very disheartening, because that she would say that she would be him instead of love him for who he is, because there's already enough violence out here against and towards gays. So he just felt like that wasn't the right thing to say, and he was like, he understand that as a mother you would want your son to be straight or whatever, but he was just like, why, if he chooses to be gay or if he turns out to be gay, then, you know, why not just love him for who he is? So I don't know. I know this is a big controversy topic. It's a really touchy subject at that as well. I mean, everybody has their own opinion towards it and everybody's gonna feel differently. I just felt it was, I don't have much to say on it because I know it's a touchy subject. I just don't feel like it was a need for her, one, to tweet that, and two, to even speak about it on the Breakfast Club. She was basically trying to clarify and just, like, bring some type of justice to what she was saying, and instead of just apologizing for the tweet at home, because she didn't. I think she should have just apologized and was like, you know what I said was wrong, I shouldn't have said that. Even if you feel that way about your son, don't say you're gonna beat him, and don't, like, I don't know. That's, I mean, you just gotta watch what you say when you in the limelight, because everybody takes it differently and somebody is gonna take it the wrong way. But that's how I feel about that situation. All right, moving on. Next topic, y'all, is about Lil Mama, the rapper Lil Mama. I don't know if y'all remember Lil Mama. She was had to hit some lip gloss. My lip gloss is popping. My lip gloss is cool, you know. So she ain't made no music in forever, but she's trying to make a comeback, y'all. She done moved back to Atlanta. She's on a new season of Growing Up in Hip Hop Atlanta, and she's trying to put out a new album for her fans. She's even thinking about going into singing. She said she's been singing all her life, but she just went into rapping. Her mama really wanted her to be a singer, a singer instead of a rapper, but basically, y'all know the incident that happened with Lil Mama years ago when she got up on the stage of the Jay-Z and Alicia Keys performance when they were singing in New York, there's some, and she got up on the stage during the performance, you know, did that big whole incident ruining the performance. So basically, Lil Mama say she tired. Sis said she is tired of y'all asking her about that incident. She said there's no point of y'all keep asking her because it's not bringing no type of solutions. And people just want to, like, people feel some type of way because it's like when they be interviewing her, the brat said when she interviewed her, actually, that she felt like she had somewhat of an attitude when they was talking about it and they asked about it. And Lil Mama like, why do I have to keep talking about this? Why is it, like, why? And people like, well, you did it. So people want to know why you did it. And now, from years later, do you have any type of remorse? That's what her mentor, rapper MC Light, said to her. She was like, they waiting to see if you feel remorseful. Like, what about the situation? And she like, remorseful? Like, are you kidding me? Like, why? Why do I need to feel remorseful? So Lil Mama wasn't having it, honey. She was mad. She feel like y'all ain't bringing no light to the situation. It ain't causing any. It's over with. It's done. It's in the past. And y'all ain't bringing no solutions. So why ask her about it? I say, I don't know how y'all feel about what Lil Mama said. Do y'all agree? Disagree? I feel one. She can't get mad at the people for asking her. That's their job. They're interviewing you. You're a celebrity. Did something you did that was that brought controversy. That was a big event that you ruined. And regardless if it had however long ago it happened, people, that's something they're gonna ask you about because you did it. Just like if you would have went to jail. They're gonna always ask you about going to jail, even though you might have went to jail, did your time, you out, and you like, I don't want to talk about that part of my life no more. You know, people still gonna ask you. So I feel like she shouldn't be taking it. She shouldn't feel no type of way. And she shouldn't be taking it no type of way with them asking her, about the incident. But I also get where she coming from. Like, she like, leave it alone, let it go. Why is I'm still being asked about this? She trying to work on a new project. She done moved to a new city. She just trying to do big things now. And she just like, ask me about that stuff. Don't ask me about this the most. She tired of answering and talking about it. So I could feel her on that too, because it could get annoying. But like MC Light said, you got to bring a different light to it. You got to show some type of remorse. Are you sorry that you did it? Or, you know, be able to talk about it and then switch it back to what you're working on now. Like, you have to be able to know how to answer these questions and know how to talk about these things when they be thrown at you or whatever. I just thought that was funny that she went off because she mad because they keep asking her about it. But people bad that you were on stage, Lil Mama. Why did you do that anyway? And I mean, I don't know if y'all remember that, that performance at the award show when she did that. That was crazy because nobody knew, like, why did she go on stage? And like, when you was watching the award show itself, the camera had cut and all you seen was, next thing you just seen was her on stage. You didn't even see how she got up there. Everybody like, what is she doing on stage? But now if you watch clips back and see some other clips that have came about, that's all over social media today. Like, she even, Beyonce even tried to stop her. And she pulled away from Beyonce. It was like, no, get off me. And tried to get on stage. So, it's like, it's crazy. But it was real funny. But I'm just still trying to, we just confused Lil Mama, sis. We just want you to clarify. We just want you to clear it up. That's all. We just want to know why you did it. Are you sorry for doing it? Have you apologized to Jay-Z for ruining his performance? Like, we just want no details, sis. Ain't that big a deal. But y'all, let's take another quick break and we'll be back after this. Oh.
Like Phil and Lil.
And with one wish, blank grant you one trip. When we go on this adventure, who you wanna come with? See, you're my little brother that I'll come get. Run with, but it got to be done quick. Though Chucky is scared, and Tommy is sad. And Phil and Lil missing your mommy and dad. So pick a time and date, and find a place. And I guarantee you that we all get home safe.
Was a good old throwback. That was Take Me Back by Maya, and that used to be on the Rugrats movie. If any of y'all 90s kids are out there, that was the good old throwback music. All right, moving on to the next topic. So basically, Rob Kardashian files legal documents to lower child support payments. He says he can no longer afford the $20,000 a month payment. So Rob Kardashian has a baby with Blac Chyna. The baby name is Dream. When they broke up, Chyna put Rob on child support, and the $20,000 I feel is a kind of ridiculous. But Rob doesn't work. Everybody know Rob don't work. His family takes care of him, the whole Kardashian clan. So of course I've been wondering this whole time anyway how he been affording to pay for this $20,000 anyway, because he don't work. So the Shade Room posted about how Rob filed documents to get the payments lowered. In the comment section is where all the drama started. So in the comment section, basketball player Matt Barnes, who is going through his own legal battle over his twins with his wife in court, he dropped the black fist emoji in the comments, saying that he supports Rob and him getting the payments lowered because he feels that, hey, he's trying to support another brother trying to go through going through the same problems he's going through. Black China responds not in a very good way because Black China doesn't like anybody trying to comfort her, so she always has to come back with drama. So Black China said, she commented back to Matt Barnes basically saying that, "I don't know you, bruh. Mind your business, loser." Oh, Black China. So when she put that comment, Matt then responds back to Black China saying, "Back to the pole you go." So it's no secret, everybody knows that Black China is a known stripper. Before she became, you know, well, she started dating famous rappers and being friends with Kim Kardashian, which made her famous, like Instagram famous, and then she became even more famous with dating black rappers. She stopped stripping then, so she's known for dating these rappers, people that's in the business famous, and then, you know, taking their money, you know, and spend it on what she want. So it was no secret that she was a, you know, used to be a stripper. So it was just, I thought it was funny that Matt Barnes responded that in the way that he did, "Back to the pole you go," because, hey, she was talking about she made a lot of money doing that, and I feel she know Rob don't got no money, so I don't know why she's charging that man $20,000 for this baby, because she don't even take care. Literally, she has nannies. So many nannies that take care of them kids if Dream is not with Rob. So I guess that's what she need $20,000 for, to pay for the nannies. You know, no shade, sis, you know, all tea, no shade, but I'm just saying. So I just thought that was just so funny how this going back and forth. So after Matt said that China was not happy, obviously she went to Instagram posting several videos saying that, basically, you know, "I don't know you, bruh," and showing all her different expensive cars she has and saying that it's paid with her own money and that she don't use her child support money to buy what she want, because she was responding to what Matt, when he went to make videos, saying that he wasn't trying to start no problems. Like, she came at him, he was just trying to support another fellow person going through the same thing he was going through, and saying that, "I don't know why women out here always trying to request so much money for this child support." He's like, "You don't need $20,000 to take care of no one child a month." Like, he's like, "That's ridiculous. She definitely using that money to go out of town and buy purses and buy whatever she want. Like, that's crazy." So, you know, China had to respond. She's just like, "Why you keep speaking on me, and you don't know nothing about me? I make my own coin and I bought all this with my own money. I don't use child support money." So they basically going back and forth over Instagram on about the child support while Rob is sitting pretty and silent, because Rob ain't said nothing. All Rob ain't comment on nothing. He ain't responded to nothing. He ain't put his two cents in nothing. Rob said, "My name is Bennett and I ain't in it, honey." Rob said, "I'm just out here trying to live my best life. I'm trying to get this child support lowered so I don't go broke." That's what he said. Because Rob just like, "Y'all can go back and forth if y'all want to. I'm out here just trying to get this child support lowered. So what's up?" And I feel robbed, because that's a lot of money. $20,000 a month? That's a lot. Like, what is y'all doing with the $20,000? What is the $20,000 going towards? Because she's still a baby. Like, she's not even that old. Where is the $20,000 going towards? I want to know too, sis. Like, dang. But, I mean, hey. Y'all do what you gotta do. On the other note, we're going to talk about the shooting that took place during rapper Tekashi 6ix9ine video shoot in Beverly Hills. So basically, Tekashi was doing a video shoot with Kanye and Nicki Minaj for one of his new videos in Beverly Hills, and Kanye and Tekashi was there getting ready and everything. Nicki Minaj was not there yet. Reported from TMZ, it was said that 8 shots were reportedly fired and only one made it into the house. No one was injured. Tekashi was supposed to be filming with Kanye West and Nicki Minaj, but Nicki reportedly had not shown up by the time the shots were fired. Kanye left immediately after. I bet Kanye did leave. He was like, let me get my behind out of here because I ain't trying to get shot. Like, Kanye always got something to say, but he ain't about that life. He ain't about that trying to get shot life. I feel you, Kanye, though. I ain't about it either, honey. I would have been gone too. As soon as I heard the first shot, I'm gone. I'm out of here. Sorry. Sorry, honey, can't shoot today. Nope. I'm gonna need more money too, cause I ain't come here to try to get shot up. you know what I'm saying? So, TMZ reported that the room that received the bullets was Nicki Minaj's room. Was supposed to be, I guess, her dressing room, and thankfully she wasn't there. So TMZ said they heard that the room was initially supposed to be for Tekashi's. Supposed to be Tekashi's room, but he decided he wanted to switch. Ain't that a coincidence? So you decide to switch rooms and the room that's supposed to be yours get shot up. So thoughts, what are y'all thoughts? My thoughts, I'm gonna tell y'all what I thought for real. When I first read this story, before all the details came out, y'all, I'm finna tell y'all what I really thought happened. Okay, so basically when they said somebody shot up the video shoot, and it was like, it was the room that Nicki Minaj was being, but Nicki wasn't there yet, because reportedly Nicki always show up late to stuff. Girl, I thought Cardi B was out here putting out another hit on people. Y'all know Cardi had to go to court for putting out a hit on some strippers at a bar who came for her something. She put a hit out on them, honey. So I thought Cardi was out here putting out a hit on, so you know Cardi and Nicki be going back and forth with this beef for the longest, and Nicki keep coming for Cardi. So I thought Cardi was, you know, fed up. She like, oh, I'm gonna show you because you keep trying me, girl. And I really thought, I was like, Lord, please don't let it come back on Cardi. Please don't say that Cardi done sent somebody out to put a hit on Nicki, trying to get Nicki shot out here, scare Nicki. I don't know, but I really thought it was Cardi. But I'm so glad it wasn't. I'm like, Cardi being a bigger person, Lord, she ain't send no hit out on nobody again. Because she know she will be in jail. She know she'll be in jail. Like, she was lucky to get out of that one. So I'm glad she didn't. But I really thought it was going to come down to Cardi trying to put a hit on Nicki. So I'm like, dang, they was targeting Nicki. Nicki was supposed to get shot. But then more details came out, and it was like, that dressing room was meant to be for Tekashi, and he switched. So whoever knew that was supposed to be his room, and they was trying to get him, honey. But thank goodness Nicki was not there, because that one bullet that made it inside the house could have hit her and she would have been hurt or maybe dead. So that's the good thing that she was not there. Yeah, that's crazy. I just feel Tekashi always has some type of drama following behind him everywhere he go, because he puts himself in danger. He always with that drama, and he always beefing with somebody. So people always trying to come fight or bring violence wherever he go. So I wouldn't even want to be around him. Like, I'm surprised Kanye even decided to agree to do video shoot with him, because I don't know. I mean, all the news I see on him in the media, it's always negative. I mean, it's some positive stuff out there that he do for his people, but he always beefing with somebody, and it's always violence behind it. And I wouldn't want to roll with nobody who got violence and so much beef. A lot of people got so much beef against them, because I'm not trying to get shot, and I don't want to be targeted when they trying to get you. Like, you know what I mean? Don't bring none of that negative energy my way. So if it, I mean, so if Nikki was there, that would have been on his hands. Her blood would have been on his hands. That would have been his fault. So he better pray. He was saved by God. He better pray. And thank God that she wasn't there and that it didn't escalate more than it would have, like that it could have. Like Kanye was like, I'm dipping. I'm out of here. I ain't trying to get shot. Dang. I don't know if they have plans to get back together and try to reshoot the video, because I don't think they had even started shooting the video when this happened. So, but if I was Nikki, I'd be scared. I wouldn't want to go even try to shoot no more videos with homie, because I'm not finna get shot, because you need to handle your beef before you try to do any type of business with anybody. You feel me? But that's all the news for today, guys. That's all the hot topics. Thank you so much for tuning in and supporting your girl. This has been Jada with the Tea, and happy holidays as well, y'all. I know Thanksgiving is coming up, so happy Thanksgiving. Don't get too full. Don't stuff your stomachs too much. And hope y'all enjoy y'all holidays, and thanks for listening. Bye.
Thought I'd end up with Sean, but it wasn't a match. Wrote some songs about Ricky, now I listen and laugh. Even almost got married, and for Pete I'm so thankful. Wish I could say thank you to Malcolm, 'cause he was an angel. One taught me love, one taught me patience, one taught me pain. Now I'm so amazing. Said loved and I've lost, that's not what I see. So look what I got, look what you taught me. Yeah, for that I say thank you, next, next. Thank you, next, next. Thank you, next. I'm so grateful for my ex. Thank you, next, next. Thank you, next, next. Spend more time with my friends, I ain't worried about nothing. Plus I met someone else, we having better discussions. I know they say I move on too fast, but this one gon' last, 'cause her name is Ari, and I'm so good with that. So good. She taught me love, she taught me patience, how she handles pain. That's amazing. Something happens, at least this song is a smash.